happened to you not the night before Christmas. A fractured tail from the night before Christmas. And all through the house, every creature was stirring, especially the mouse.
The cookies were stuffed in the freezer with care, all ready for Grandpa, who would soon be there.
While Mom in her apron and I in my cat, I showed Frosty our cat who was taking a nap.
But out in the kitchen, I heard a big clatter that sprang from his chair to look in the matter.
Away to the door, I flew like a flash box. Fell in the eggs with a crash.
Mom raced behind him to help where she could, exploded with laughter as other girls would.
But flour all over my husband, so dear.
So like an old rooster, I roam broken eggs, but thank God I was conscious without broken legs.
More rapid than eagles, the children they came. Mom whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Donald, now Daniel, now Daryl and Dale, come Deborah, come Darla, come Gary and Gil. Grab rags and your dad, grab the broom and the pan, now clean away, fast as you can.
Like doctors who fly to the scene of a crash, the children all flew to obey with a dash.
Get up, Daddy, your poor clothes are a mess. You're tripping and slipping from battle, I guess.
We're sorry this stuff is all over the room. We'll clean it all up with some rags and a broom.
And then in a twinkling, I heard from my wife the giggles and toots like a boy with a fife.
Dad wobbled his head and was turning around when Frosty appeared coming in with a bag.
All dressed in cat fur from his head to his toes, his tail is now flapping like soft rubber hose.
A mousekin so dear had hung from his teeth. It wiggled and jiggled from sheer to spring.
Oh, cat eyes, how they twinkled. His whiskers seemed merry. His tail now a flagpole, his nose like a berry.
His cute little mouth was drawn up like a bow. The ears on his head were as white as the snow.
Poor tail of the mouse, he held light in his teeth. The awe and then stool crowned his head like a wreath.
Our frosty soft face and his litter and belly had scared the poor mouse who was shaking like jelly.
The mousekin was chubby, not a jolly old elf. I laughed when I saw it in spite of myself.
Dad blinked his left eye and twisted his head while watching the show by the cats who dwelt there.
He had spoke not a word but went straight to his work and carried poor mouse to the door with a jerk.
Then, waving his tail like a flag in the wind, he blinked and he nodded and shared a big grin.
I jumped to the door and it flung wide open. Our cat freed that mouse. Empty teeth raced inside. Soft.
He sprung to his chair since his duty was done and gave us the story to Sarah Gus for fun.
May